It was a functional music, a music that was sung by the people. And quite often, when I see solo performances of the spiritual, I only see one character. And there were always at least two characters. So I'm not going to talk that much about it, but we have a singer that's ready to go. I don't know if Right on King Jesus, maybe Watch and Pray is ready. Watch and Pray? Okay. Okay. Would you come? And tell us your name. Okay.
My name is Sarah Adams.
Okay, Sarah. And tell us a little bit about what you're singing.
I'll be singing Watch and Pray, arranged by Andrew Smith Moore. It's a really heartbreaking sorrow song. Basically, a child asking her mom if their master is going to sell them tomorrow, and her mom says yes, and that all they can do is watch and pray.
So in this, we have at least two characters. Yes?
Yes.
It doesn't necessarily have to be two. She could have more than one child. Okay? Which is an idea. How do you feel about singing without your glasses?
Oh, I can do that, yeah.
Okay. All right. Do you know anything about Undine Smith Moore?
I know, like, factoids. Like,
okay.
Born, like, 1905, 1904. She was the granddaughter of slaves. She considered herself a teacher more than a composer, which is interesting. Yeah.
You know, many of the people in this room knew her, and she was a very elegant woman. I think I sang my freshman year in college, I sang a master class where she was a master teacher. A beautiful, elegant woman, you know. And who was this piece written for?
Well, I don't know, actually.
Her student, Camilla Williams. And so you should look that name up, Camilla Williams. Okay. Great soprano.
Mama is not small to say.
the genius of this piece is that Undine Smith Moore has made this into a shana. You know what a shana is?
Not really.
Like a scene. Okay. Like an operatic scene. Okay? And this, any idea what that might be?
I always thought of it as kind of like a cry.
A cry? A holler?
Yeah.
Okay. Who's doing the hollering?
I think the mother.
The mother?
Yeah.
Okay. No wrong answer. It's whatever you can sell.
Okay.
Okay. I need a volunteer. Will you be a volunteer for me? I need a volunteer. And I need you to sit here.
Okay.
You have to get this in your mind's eye of all of these characters. Would you play the introduction for me again? What's happening to you during this introduction? And it's not I'm scared to death and what are my words and all of that. That's your introduction. What could be happening there?
Maybe seeing your child come in.
Okay.
Come into the room, sit down, like maybe you're sitting and they're looking up at you and you know what they're about to ask.
I love that idea about the child coming in. Does the child know that they're going to be sold?
No. Well, maybe, but
and,
they're...
In acting, the answer is always yes.
Okay.
Are you in love? Yes. Do you know? Yes. Because if you say no, you cut off so many opportunities. Okay? Alright? So she knows. But what is she asking from Mama? She wants Mama to tell her no.
Yeah.
Okay? And so as Mama, you can't be so eager to answer. I want you to come in as a child on this introduction. I want you to make eye contact with Mama. I want you to then come to her and I want you to kneel and I want you to ask her. Okay? Alright? And believe it or not, all of this is going to help how you sing this.
Mom, Dad, it must have gone a cell lost more.
sometimes you think with these spirituals, oh, we can sing whatever we want to, and as long as the pianist plays us on the page, we can pull what we want. This is really like a shame. This is really like an art song, so you really have to be kind of true to the music. And it's all there. The build-up is all there. Now I want you to play Mama.
Thank you.
think is so powerful if the girl begins that I got a mom watching pray. Could be the girl saying watch and pray. It could be mama saying watch and pray again. You know, so many things. How it looks and see it all in your mind. I play the movie in your mind. Okay? Let's hear the introduction again. Play that movie, because when you do this, you show us all. Stay here, but see the movie in your mind's eye.
Witness.
that the singer expresses no personal connection. He gives no testimony about himself as a biblical narrative. So Ezekiel saw the wheel. Okay? The singer is just telling the story. Ezekiel saw the wheel. Joshua did the battle of Jericho. Okay? Now, witness is not a jubilee because the singer says, my soul is a witness for my Lord. So he tells all these stories. But the most important thing is he's saying, just like this one, my soul is a witness for my Lord. I was interested in singing this, and I called Benjamin Matthews. Some of you here know Benjamin Matthews. He's passed away, and then Ben Matthews and William Warfield and I had a trio called Regeneration, and we traveled for about 2.5 years until Mr. Warfield passed away, and then Ben passed away, and then Mr. Shirley joined us for a concert, and Ben was an expert at spiritual, and I said, Ben, I want to sing Witness, and I said, but I'm having trouble with it. He said, you know, witnesses are right. That's why you're having problems with it, Robert. You can't write. and so he gave me this exercise, which was wonderful for this. And we're going to try it. First of all, can you say witness and no T?
Witness.
Witness. That's the one with no T. And I want you to do a little exercise with me.
Law.
they didn't believe. The same came to Christ, and I wanted to be taught how the human sight, the Nicodemus was a man designed to know. Can you speak it for me, Anna?
Now there was a
man of the Pharisees, yeah. Wanted to be taught out of human sight. A Nicodemus was a man.
Desire to know how a man can be born when he is old.
Christ told Nicodemus,
as a man, you must be born again.
Said Mama, not man.
If you want to be wise, repent, believe, and do not die.
Then
you will be a witness for my
Jesus Christ, the first and last man, who's a king for years, oh, kings and years, oh.
heard you in the competition, and I thought, fantastic. You support your high voice beautifully, but you let the support go for your lower and middle voice. But guess what? I'm going to ask you, if you don't mind, you should never ask a woman their age. Do you mind telling me your age?
18.
You're 18 years old, okay? And what a magnificent instrument. And, you know, when you're dealing with, how long have you studied voice?
About 2.5 years.
2.5 years. And so, are you and your teacher working on things to bridge the top and the middle down? What are you doing? You're doing...
So, a bunch of it is mostly in warm-ups.
In warm-ups.
And we study, well, we don't really study, but we do touch on a few pieces that are in that lower register, or like if I passaggio or things in that nature.
Right. And there are many ways you can do it. Some people might think that using the oo vowel and bringing oo down, because that will connect beautifully down into your middle voice. Some people might think E, it brings the vocal cords closer to together in E than in U and A. So there'd be many ways to do that. But one of the things you can do is not give up your support on it, okay? Which is great. You have a wonderful feel for this. Right on King Jesus, this is, Hall Johnson did this quite a bit, putting two spirituals together. One spiritual is right on King Jesus, the other spiritual, he is King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Two different spirituals. UZ Brown does that a lot. He'll bring in another spiritual. Roland Carter does that a lot. Will bring in another spiritual. And so these are two different spirituals, all right? And you have to know what is the call and the response of the two different spirituals, okay? But I instinctively, you know, I'm getting that from you. It's also, think of this as, you have this introduction, bum, bee, bum. What is that for you, personally? What is the scene that you're setting for yourself?
Church.
Church? Okay. Is it a testimony? What for you?
No, not necessarily. It was more just, you know, choirs coming on, dun, 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 and everyone's like getting ready to.
That's good enough. The answer's always yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. There is. It's pomp and circumstance. Yes, this introduction, as short as it may be, in all octaves, right? It could be just you. It could be the minister. Mm-hmm. There's often the minister in the spirituals, okay? The minister and the congregation responded, all right? Or it could be you giving a testimony. What does it mean by no man can hinder me? Hinder. You use it. Did anybody in your family use that word?
No.
What hinders me?
I would assume what clouds me, but through context, so no man can cloud me or take away what I...
That's another word. Another word. Stop. Yeah. Stop. And so, what is your overall idea about this piece?
Nobody can stop me because King Jesus,
who was like master. I love it. If Jesus can do it, why hinders me? He said, greater things shall I do. What hinders me? Right on, King Jesus. If you said it, no man can hinder me. And then you start thinking to yourself, he's the King of Kings. He's the Lord. Yeah, Jesus Christ, the first and the last. No man, what else did he do? Yeah, that kind of thing. Okay, all right. That might be a whole other character. Okay. And then at the end, okay, Ann, let's do it again. That middle voice is there. Now, I don't want you to chest it there, okay? I don't want you to do that. But you can bring that down and it'll mix, okay, Ann? Good. man. Or he is the second spiritual man.
For he is King of Kings, he is Lord of Lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man looks like him. For he is King of Kings.
Wait, sir. For he is King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Oh, Jesus Christ, the first and the last, no man works like him. For he is King. Make something with that breath, okay? Carrying that over. And not so fast. Don't think. For he am.
For he is King of Kings.
Yeah.
He is Lord of Lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last. No man works like him. For he is King of Kings. He is Lord of Lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last. No man works like him.
What about it?
Jesus rides on the white horse. No man.
What else did he do? Wonderful.